Can you drive to this one?
Fine. Where are we headed? You read that those goddamn Chinese want to sell the relief food that we're sending them?
Yeah. Yeah, I read about that.
These people are starving. They can't do that.
They want to sell the food to fund the civil war against the communists.
Really? Guess that's okay, then.
Armies can't fight without food. You can spend all your money on weapons, but you still have to have the will to fight. Fortunately, the Reds will win in China.
Watch your mouth. You know what you're saying?
The people of this country overthrew a king. You think the Chinese will balk at an emperor if they are starving?
What can I do for you?
LAPD, Phelps and Galloway. We're making inquiries into the murder of Evelyn Summers.
Evelyn? She's dead?
You knew Evelyn Summers, Mr.
Robbins. Yes, I knew Evelyn. I was a good friend of her ex-husband. She kept some of her stuff here.
Can you show us, please?
Sure. Come this way.
Got some fine stock here, Mr. Robbins. Well, you let us take some for the road, this case might get solved a lot quicker.
He's joking, Mr. Robbins.
She kept a bed here, but I probably shouldn't have let her. An alcoholic in a liquor store, that was never gonna work out, was it?
We'll take a look around. Rawlings Bowling Alley. Maybe Evelyn did something other than drink in her spare time.
Rawlings. I know that place. Corner of 9th and Graham. A lot of cops bowl there on Tuesday nights.
I'm guessing Evelyn hadn't held down a job for quite some time before she was killed.
When exactly did Evelyn work in the pictures?
2 years ago. She worked in legal copyrights for years.
Evelyn was reading Aristotle?
Evelyn wasn't stupid. The only stupid thing about her was her need to drink.
And she was borrowing books from Grosvenor McCaffrey. She wasn't always such a loner. We're trying to account for Evelyn's movements yesterday.
She came by in the morning.
A social visit? To pick up some of her things?
She had a couple of bucks and bought a quart of rye.
Any idea where the money came from?
She didn't mention it. But she did say the booze was a present for a boy. She said they had been fighting and she had to make it up to him.
Were you and Evelyn close, Mr. Robbins?
Not many people will be sad she's gone. I'll be one of the few.
I got the impression that Evelyn had been sleeping rough of late.
It became difficult for me to have her staying here. Her mother was trying to get her back on the straight and narrow. She's old now. And to be honest, you have to have a good reason to want to get back on.
Do you know a friend of Evelyn's by the name of McCaffrey?
Not personally.
We're struggling for leads, Robbins. Did she know McCaffrey?
She idolized him. From what I gather, the feeling was far from mutual. He seems to peddle a revolutionary stance, fixing the ills of society. You could see how it would appeal to down-and-outs like Evelyn.
Thanks for your help, Mr. Robbins.
No problem. Hey, I'd like to make arrangements for the funeral. You think I could get in touch with Evelyn's mother?
Put in a call to the watch commander at Central Station, Mr. Robbins. He'll be trying to reach the next of kin.
Thanks. Get the guy, huh? Evelyn never hurt anybody.
You can drive.
And where exactly are we going?
Galloway, homicide. We need to ask you some questions concerning Evelyn Summers.
I'm Walter Match. Evelyn Summers, what is it now?
You knew Evelyn?
As well as I wanted to know Evelyn. She's a pain in the ass, always coming in here, cadging drinks, never had any money. She was in just a couple of nights ago.
Did she ever tell you where she was staying?
I don't know. I think she was living rough. She had that kind of stunk about her.
Who did she drink with?
A bunch of these guys. Ask around.
What's your name?
Grosvenor McCaffrey.
Mind if I ask you some questions, Mr. McCaffrey?
I'm just a starving writer, detective. What do you want to ask about?
Evelyn Summers, and why she was found beaten and strangled in the rail depot on Santa Fe.
Okay. I see your point.
How well did you know her?
I can't say that I knew her. It was more like I was aware of her.
Do you have a criminal record, Mr. McCaffrey?
Nothing serious. I've had a few skirmishes.
You want to save me some time, or do you want me to look up your file?
Industrial disputes, strikes, workers' rights.
A regular fifth columnist. Nice to meet you, comrade.
You say you barely knew Evelyn?
Yes, that is correct.
You're lying, McCaffrey. You looked down your nose at Evelyn, but you knew her, and you have some idea of what happened.
I hope you're holding aces. I'm telling you again, I barely knew the woman.
Why would you lend her your book on metaphysics if you only knew her in passing? It was more than that. A Renaissance man like yourself lending his books to his acolytes.
She hounded me about that goddamn book, and then she lifts it from my apartment and lies to my face that she didn't take it, as if she could even comprehend any of it. I saw her go into a hotel with Tiernan last night. They had booze in a paper bag. He's your man.
Thank you for the information, Mr. McCaffrey.